And with that, folks, we're actually in. Sorry, we had a bit of a full stall there for a second because the lobby did not actually load. But once again, welcome to Stall Out of China I-League. We have got Team Fantuan versus FTD Club C. I believe Fantuan is most famously known as containing F Z S M J DDR and in July. Either way, let's get right into this because the draft has begun. Once again, I am Llama Down Under. I am joined by the wonderful Noble Wings from a
Ten
great North
seconds
American team called
remaining.
Lonely Boys. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
Five
How about
seconds
you?
remaining.
I am excited. I feel like our first foray into Chinese Dota as casters
Five
was very
seconds.
exciting last game, and I am happy. I'm hoping this game, because I feel like even though, DK ended out. Well, XDK, I feel, outperformed Braveheart in most of those team heights. It still felt very even. So, I'm hoping this
Yeah,
is a good set.
absolutely. Should
But
be good games.
we have the same bands coming out, and the Chinese scene seems to be much more in
Ten
favor of
seconds
giving up the
remaining.
Quap and the SF. I know SF really not
Five
something
seconds
they
remaining.
give up to a lot of the North American teams, you know?
Radiant
Yeah, I
team.
mean, it's weird. They ban offlaners every game. This is
Yeah.
the third time now they banned four offlaners in the first four bans.
I think it makes a lot of
Radiant
sense.
team pick.
It could just be something where maybe they've decided this patch not the best for zoning folks out, but it also, yeah, maybe it's just a preference. They just prefer the weak offlane as they'd rather deal with big mids. So, not quite sure myself, but as we talked about, Wyvern making it through obviously picked up. Actually, something which doesn't see as much pick in the West,
Dire
certainly
team
gets
pick.
picked in the Western scene, but maybe not always as high a priority. But we've got the Queen of Pain Spiritbreaker opener from FTD Club, and Queen of Pain pretty nice against a Wyvern. Lots of stuff that goes through that cold embrace.
Yeah, and when you pick a Queen of Pain this early, it just means your mid lane is gonna be no fun for whoever you pick. I mean, all the common mid laners now don't have a good time versus Quap. Windranger doesn't do too well. Shadow
Ten
Fiend doesn't do
seconds
well.
remaining.
Ember gets pretty much destroyed. He has kill potential, but he
Five
still
seconds
loses the lane
remaining.
pretty badly in
Yeah.
CS. There's not really any good answer to Quap right now for the mid lane.
Reserves.
Yeah, I just, as you said, strong laner. She can even be your, if you need, she can be your offlaner as well. So if we see the continuing trend of banning all the offlaners, she's flexible there. And Spiritbreaker, of course, can go there as well. Now, for Team Fantuan, whose background is a triangle, I really hope that's instead of rice triangle. I like rice, but that's not important. We're gonna be. I wonder whether they're gonna go for something like the Ember here, maybe safe lane it so he doesn't have to deal with the Quap horrible lane, or what else they might decide on. Could be another. Oh, Shadow
A
Fiend.
Shadow Fiend.
Dire team
Yeah.
back.
And one thing I will say is that Chinese teams seem to really like Spirit Breaker. I mean, he's been picked in all three games, and I'm surprised they're just letting it through. Or even if they're letting it through, it's getting picked so early in the first
10
phase.
seconds
It
remaining.
feels like he's dropped off a bit in the Western scene, but
5 seconds remaining.
he's dropped off in the Western scene in favor of running Tusk, who
Reserves
often
back.
makes it out in the Western scene just because Quap is always banned, I
Radiant
think, is
team
the way to
back.
put that. Quap and Shadow Fiend being banned means that Tusk makes it through a bit more, and then it does feel like Tusk maybe can do a bit more than a Spirit Breaker or more reliably get kills.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I mean, I was looking at the Frankfurt stats, and even at Frankfurt right now, Spiritbreaker is the 21
Dire team
most
back.
picked hero, so it's not like he's
Yeah.
been like top of the line. But here we've seen him first phase picked three times in a row, so
And I
I don't
really
know.
think it's just the constant banning of Tusk instead of heroes like the Queen of Pain. And
Ten
we also
seconds
saw
remaining.
last game, last series, we saw Earthshaker picked or banned in both. It just
Five
means that you
seconds
have to find
remaining.
other ways to get work done, and Spirit Breaker, of course, can be one of those without a Tusk or an Earthshaker.
Reserves
But
back.
we are getting into more offlaners being banned. Finally, a Gyrocopter who is not an offlaner. That'll be something for us. But a Nightstalker who you can argue can be played support,
Radiant
can be played
team
offlaner.
back.
So bringing some hell to that. The ban out on the Darkseer, of course, we already mentioned strong offlaner, but could also indicate that FTD Club wants to go with one of those really weak carries who just can't deal with the Darkseer in lane.
I think it could be that. It's
Ten
also
seconds
Winter Wyvern Darkseer is like known as one of the big combos in the game. You just ult someone with the Winter Wyvern ult, and then you vacuum them all into it. It's a pretty feared combo. I was actually kind of surprised they didn't first pick it. If I was Team Fantoon, I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm sorry for.
I would say Fantoon, but I also Fantoon. Don't know because I am not that kind of Asian. So we're.
Yeah. We're out of luck. I'm sorry for anyone I offend. In advance, I'm surprised they didn't first pick it, get the Winter Wyvern and the Darkseer out right away, get the combo, and Shadow Fiend Winter Wyvern is still a great combo, and they pick up Ember Spirit on top of that, too.
Yeah, I mean, I like the Ember Spirit Wyvern have some synergy. It's not... Well, it's definitely going to help you kill the cursed unit, but of course you don't get as much damage to those other units since there's 70% damage reduction on cursed people. Oh, and we can find the beautiful sunbug is still in the game, where if you click on hero skills during the draft, you get the sun that pops up. That's fine. Yeah, you like that? Anyway, I hear you clicking. Ancient Apparition here, I like, but now we're getting to the territory of you don't have a lot of stable lockdown for the Ember Spirit.
Yeah, and I don't think Bounty Hunter helps this. It's, maybe Quap can consider going for Orchid, try to lock down Ember Spirit that way, but as of now, they still have no way to reliably shut down Ember. And they need a carry, so I can't really think of any carries off the top of my head that have a lot of lockdown that they could really pick.
Yeah, they can certainly try to run a Sven or someone, but even that, I mean, this Queen of Pain... There's a number of different builds you can go on a Quap. I feel like she has to get a very fast Orchid for this to work out. She has to get a fast Orchid, force that Ember Spirit into the Manta or the Lincoln Sphere, and even then, it feels like they're playing with time. And now a Clockwork from Fantoin. That is, you know, an offlaner that's gotten through. Maybe not the best against the Queen of Pain, unless she's out of position early, when she doesn't have levels in the Blink Strike, but it can certainly pick off an AA and maybe even a Spirit Breaker here.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, there's not many other offlaners left in the pool after the consistent 7 out of 8 bans being on offlaners, but I like the Clockwork pickup here. It's good versus Spirit Breaker. It may have some issues versus Quap, but AA and Bounty Hunter still don't have any way to get out of it, and AA likes to sit at the back of the fights, and Clockwork can do a really nice job of just getting in there and being able to pick him off maybe before he is able to get his ultimate down in a good spot.
Yeah, definitely. Something else I want to mention that I know people are going crazy over in chat. This does mean this is a Yafet's Shadow Fiend. I probably pronounced this wrong, but I believe that is ZMSJ is his other name. I could be wrong on this, but he is kind of the old school, well-known pub stompy, like maybe even 10 years ago now, pub stomp Shadow Fiend from China. So, also known as PIS, I believe.
Is he? Oh, I didn't know that.
I think so. I could be completely wrong and lying to you all. I could have just made a fool of myself on the internet. And you know what they say about that? It's going to be there forever.
So. Chats is spamming Yafet's Shadow Fiend. Yeah. I don't think that's...
No, I think it is, but I'm not sure. Oh, gosh. Well, let me quickly look it up and confirm my suspicions. I believe it was him, but again, I could just be... Oh, no, he's not ZMSJ. Which one is he playing under? Which tag? Oh, gosh, that's awkward.
I thought he quit. I'm out of the loop, apparently. I thought he quit for a while.
He did, and then he came back. Well, we'll find out when he picks it up. I know he's on this roster. That's awkward. I thought he might be playing... Well, that's not... Everybody's going to shun me now in chat. You can ding, 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 shame. We'll keep that on the cost and ding, 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 shame me. Huskar banned out, really well played there. I do agree that when your enemies pick up the AA, and it's always a nice hero to have in your back pocket, but they go with a Dragon Knight and not the guy I was expecting. So, yeah, I don't know which tag he's hiding under. I mean, he has to be Paparazzi or Pretty Hua, but I think Pretty Hua is a different player.
Okay.
Oh, he could also not be here today, because DDR is one of their subs, so.
Okay, so maybe he's not here, this isn't a... Yeah,
I'm sorry, chat, we may have shamed you all and made you sad, so I'm not sure if he's there or not, but he used to be in this lineup. Either way, we got a Rubick ban out, we got a DK coming out. How do you deal with a DK? A nice strong support here that'll, I feel like... That's not what I was going to say.
Yeah, that's a good call. He has a lot of magic damage to deal with the high armor of DK. He's good versus Quap, as he can get the silences off, and he's relatively good. He's not good versus Bounty Hunter, but He can deal with it during the early game as long as Winter Wyvern stays near him.
Yeah, now my only concern here for the lineup of. I feel like for Team Fantuan, we've got. You've got Winter's Curse, you've got Searing Chains, you've got Hookshot and Battery Assault.
Well, and I forgot to mention the Clockwork and Skywrath will combo really well. Something I didn't really mention.
10 seconds remaining.
They have
Five
chains too,
seconds
right?
remaining.
Unless you mention chains.
I did, but I feel like it's not. Yeah, I'm worried that
Prepare
people
for
will do the old walk away that we saw last
ambush.
game, or the old charge away, because of course Xian here can just charge out of a lot of issues that he may be having, as can. I mean, Bounty Hunter, of course, you can dust him, it slows him. Maybe that'll be enough to get him caught out. But Quap's gonna blink away. Dragonite's gonna walk away with his infinite healing. So.
Yeah, Dragonite is, well, Dragonite is actually kind of squishy. His strength gain is pretty decent at 2.8, but for a strength hero, he doesn't become that tanky. All his tankiness comes from Dragon Blood and the amount of armor he gets. So Skywrath and Clockwork should not have that tough of a time killing him, actually.
And I think a lot of this is going to come down to how much farm he gets. I'm still not sure whether he is safe lane or the Quap. Actually, I think Quap is safe lane, then, I guess, is what Quap is from that item build. So it's going to be DK in mid. Sorry, I was looking at that and I thought maybe she was going a Sol Ring because I saw a recipe and then I was like, nope, it's just maybe not the most common of builds. Either way, let's quickly introduce the teams for this first fight engagement. We've got QCC hyphen on DK, or on the, yeah, on the Dragon Knight. Not DK because that's a different team. We've got A Yuan on Ancient Apparition, Quap being played by Monet, we've got Bounty Hunter being played up by the one, the only, the man whose name I can't read in the slightest. That first character is probably not people. My Chinese is very poor, folks. And Xian on that Spirit Breaker, tossing it over to you for Fantuan.
Okay, we have Pretty Ha taking on the Skywrath Mage. We have DDR playing Winter Wyvern. We have Paparazzi playing on the Shadow Fiend, which I don't think is Yafetz. We have InjJuly taking up the Clockwork, and we have ZSMJ taking on the Ember Spirit.
Yeah, I don't know if they're using a stand-in or not, but we're just gonna assume that Paparazzi is not Yafetz. But maybe he is, folks. Maybe we'll be surprised either way. DK getting harassed up the wazoo. He was taking a lot of it, and in top lane, we can also see they're bringing it to the Spirit Breaker. So FTD are not off to a great start in any of these lanes. A lot of regen is gonna be burned. At least Bounty Hunter's bringing a bit back to DDR, but. Yeah, mid lane's gonna be rough.
Yeah, it is. I was surprised with how much like confidence they picked the DK with, I guess. Like right away, as soon as they finished their last bans, they picked DK without even waiting for reserve time. They didn't wait. They just went straight for it, and it's normally unusual as DK wasn't really a meta pick. It was kind of, I guess, maybe a pocket strat. I don't know what they want to do with it.
I also am a little surprised that they're running him in the mid. Oh, we have the blink forwards. Can Monet get more auto attacks off? And no, they're not able to reach it, even taking an auto attack on the AA, bringing him below 200 health. I'm a little surprised as well. I feel like running him safe lane is just a little bit easier. Quap can at least tie the matchup with Shadow Fiend, and if the Shadow Fiend makes a few mistakes, she can certainly has kill potential early on that hero. So I thought the Dragon Knight could maybe get a bit more out of the safe lane, and it's not like Quap is sacrificing too much by going mid.
I think it might be more of that DK. Clockwork does relatively well versus pretty much every melee in the game. They didn't really want to put the DK down there versus the Clockwork. Instead, decided to throw him mid as he might have an easier time there than versus Clockwork.
Now let's discuss full game plans. Obviously, when you run a team around a DK, you've got a couple different ways you can do it. The carry DK build, it's not a super common one we see. Oh, they had an Invis rune, they have a charge, they even have Bounty Hunter, they've got some fire coming up, but the slow, it's not enough, and Paparazzi is gonna be able to get away a couple tower attacks as well. Can he get the raise for the last hit? That is our first blood, Bounty Hunter going down. And a little bit of an overplay there. I think they thought they had enough slow with the charge with the Bounty Hunter with the Orb of Venom, but it was not to be.
Yeah, and that means Shadowfiend is going to have max souls already, so he gets 12 souls from that kill, and it's going to make mid lane really difficult for DK. And if it wasn't difficult enough, gets really hard from now on.
Yeah, he's trying to do his best with aggro pulling and giving that breathe fire debuff to Shadowfiend, where of course he does a little bit more dam a little bit less damage. But I don't know if it's gonna be enough. And I was also gonna say, I think you when you play with the DK, there's a couple different ways. Carry DK we don't see too much, but there is certainly a wait for the DK to have his ult, and then every time he has his ult, push a lane build. I don't know if these other heroes synergize so well with that.
Yeah, the issue is they don't really have any pushing besides DK, and they have a bounty hunter who's relatively useless when it comes to going for pushes. I think the way they want to play this is maybe get a fast blink dagger on DK and try to transition into maybe just trying to pick off the Ember Spirit, pick off the Shadow Fiend, and then maybe transition that way into Roshan and the towers. Because if they just five man going maybe DK into straight BKB or even maybe an SNY, they're gonna have a lot of issues trying to just push down these towers against good anti-pushers like Ember Spirit, like Winter Wyvern, Skywrath Clockwork. All these heroes are really great at making sure that you can't push down my towers, pretty much.
Yeah, I also have to say, I feel like AA Bounty Hunter, they're heroes who want to get kills team fight. AA is certainly happy to force your opponents into a drawn out team fight with that Ice Blast debuff. You know, even without the Ags, it's still 7, 8, 9 seconds, I believe. Could be 8, 9, 10. Yeah, 8, 9, 10 seconds. So it's something where you're kind of okay with a little bit of an engagement where they limp away only to shatter. DK not kind of known as the hero for that. So I'm not sure how you set up these team fights, especially when another thing to consider, I don't feel like FTD have a lot of they have a lot of single target lockdown. So how are you getting people in to stick
Radiant's
around
top
for your
tower
team
is
fights?
under attack.
Well, I don't really think it's gonna be an issue getting to stick around. I mean, you have enough lockdown, especially even on both sides. There's a good amount of lockdown on both sides, just with Clockwork being able to hook in and cog someone down with Skywrath ulti, and even on the other side with just being able to blink. I really think blink's gonna be important for this DK to make sure that he's able to initiate on whoever he wants, get a blink dagger, make sure because DK stun is, even though you don't really skill it, it is a 3.25 second stun max level. And that's a really long stun to have on an
Yeah,
instant cast.
down in bottom lane, we see an unfortunate exchange. The AA was off, I think, maybe stacking, and instead Quap goes. They managed to get the Clockwork kill. Quap goes down, but in the mid, we have another Ray. Should get them the Shadowfiend the kill. He might just be able to do this with auto attacks, and he gets it. Another attempt at a dive. This Bounty Hunter, he is not getting anything that he wants. He's only level 2. We're 6 minutes in. It feels like Bounty Hunter's a hero who even more now needs levels, just because track has been nerfed, that you can't just do not very much until you hit level 6. You have to make stuff happen just because your 6 isn't as powerful, and he is getting nothing.
Yeah, it's the thing with Bounty Hunter. He's a hit or miss hero. Sometimes you go mid, you get like 3 kills with him, and all of a sudden you're level 5 at 6 minutes as a Bounty Hunter, and you have like 500 damage a burst. But sometimes you go mid, you don't get anything done, you miss the kill by a little bit, and all of a sudden you're level 3 with not much damage, not many items, and you can't really do anything.
Yeah, so really unfortunate there, but we'll see if he can turn it around. If there are a couple big engagements, certainly this Bounty Hunter can work on getting bigger and bigger. Now, another thing I wanted to mention is both the Ember Spirit and the SF are farming insanely. Ember Spirit already has 50 CS at almost 7 minutes in. They're about 3,000 gold ahead already on Phantom at 7 minutes in, and this is without a whole heap of kills backing them up. If this continues, I'm a bit worried for FTD.
Yeah, it's gonna be difficult if Ember Spirit can get his Battle Fury at a really good timing, and it's an unusual Ember build. I haven't seen Phase Boots on Ember in a long time, like not since maybe the new patch hit. Most people have been opting for Boots of Travel or even Treads nowadays, so it's interesting to see someone pick up Phase Boots. We'll see how it plays out. I feel like by going Phase Boots, he might want to just try to fight with his team once he gets his first Battle Fury. If he wanted a split push or maybe even farm more, he would have gone Treads or Boots of Travel. And they're going on mid now.
Yeah, it's looking like they're getting themselves a nice easy kill on DK with that hookshot, and also up top we've got a little bit of action. Can they get the Searing Chance? Eats his mango, but they aren't going to be able to stop this TP, so it's going to be safety for the Spirit Breaker and Bounty Hunter. He may be going for this kill. He does have bonus damage as a melee hero. Oh goodness, oh gosh, oh gosh, you've got to get the kill. He needs one more auto attack. He's going to get that Flying Courier. Panda down, and now Clockwork with such low health, nothing he can do, so Bounty Hunter finally gets something done on this map.
That was way more important than it looked like. Shadow Fiend had a 2,000 gold Yasha on the courier right there in all of the SMJ.
Yeah, it looks like he's taking a bit of a tumble. At the same time, the immediate silence coming out. There's going to be no breathe fire, but Sonic Wave doesn't matter if you Remnant out of that. And they pop the boat, the dragon form, trying to make sure they can get off this range stun. But where is he going? Dragon Knight, he can't seem to get in and on anyone. They know that that's the hasted SF. They don't want to fight that guy. He's just going to wander away after the stun. But there it goes. They're hoping that the haste is out. And do they have the damage output? I think they do. No Requiem of Souls yet. Wyvern is coming in, but she doesn't have level 6. They have caught out the Spirit Breaker. I don't think this is necessarily the target they want. Can they not work down the clockwork? And suddenly Monet, he is taking way too much damage. He has to get out of here before another one of those bones come out. But there's going to be the stun. One more auto attack will do it. The tower should finish off the clockwork. And now their courier is going to be the one taking a tumble. Pretty Hua is taking a lot of damage from the creeps. But we have a 3-for-3 and a courier for a courier in this game. It's just 9 minutes in. What is this? What's going on?
Ember Spirit made a fantastic play. Before he died from Quapult, he put a remnant like right here around this area. And during the time that fight took, he respawned, was able to come back to that remnant and secure a bunch of kills there.
Yeah.
So that was a fantastic play by him.
And just really good map awareness, knowing what he needed to do. And again, while they got a little bit back there for FTD, Fantuan coming back in. So pretty even after that, a nice little stun from the Spirit Breaker onto Ember's Spirit, but it's not really a problem.
Yeah, the only thing you do have to worry about is Shadow Fiend is going to be closing in on his SMY. He's only 1,000 off, even though it looks like he's less, but the courier does have a full Yasha on it when it respawns. And oh, Fighting for Rune, Shadow Fiend is able to pick up the invisibility and it's Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, I think unfortunately for Bounty Hunter as well, if he were seen there, it could have been his untimely demise as Quap goes down at the other rune. Clockwork got the bounty as well, so that's particularly devastating.
They should know Shadow Fiend has an invis. DK might be, he might walk up mid.
And it looks like he really wants to get off that breathe fire, but he might just end up taking a lot of damage. There's the Requiem of Souls. He's gonna walk out of it. He won't take the whole thing. No, they keep moving around. He's gonna take the entire thing. Hey, Blast comes out. He hasn't lost all of his health, but in one more auto attack, he will, and they finish him off with the raise. They get the Wyvern with the AA Blast, but that isn't a good trade, DK, for an AA, and they are very happy on FT about that.
Clockwork killed Queen of Pain.
Yeah,
I
the bottom rune.
I think I missed that.
Yeah, he just took her. She was like, I would like to fill up my bottle. And he was like, I would like you to die. Good
the
exchange.
The thing with Quap is, it's really risky to blink forward on a Clockwork as,
She just did, again.
Well, okay, Clockwork didn't have hook there. It was okay there. But if he blinks back and he's spotted by Rocket Flare or one of those vision spells, it's really easy to just pick him off as Blink right now has a really long cooldown.
Yeah,
12
it's
seconds.
Yeah, it's actually 15, 12, 9, 6. It doesn't maybe sound that bad, but it's atrocious in mid. You actually can't, unless you are for sure going to get the kill and you know that nobody is TPing in, you basically can't blink aggressively in a lot of instances.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And if you blink aggressively and you just get too far, someone TPs in and you won't have your blink at all for the entire duration of that fight.
Yeah, it's why I feel like the Ember Spirit Quap matchup is often quite interesting, because while the Quap should be winning it just as a main ranged hero against a very weak melee hero, often the Ember Spirit may be taking advantage of levels in Flame God can catch her unawares, and we'll see if we'll see that this game, but Zed and SMJ, ZMSJ, being hunted in the jungle, I don't know if they have a nice wraparound plan here, and they're just gonna scout for stacks and probably call it a... call it a... Warding gank? No, A hasn't even placed his wards.
They're going on Shadow Fiend. Shadow Fiend's really far up right now.
He's very, very far up. Ice Blast is going to completely miss, though. And, oh, they can't push him right back in with another Blast. I think if they had the AA Blast as well, maybe they could do something. Queen of Pain isn't here. She is on her way. The stun isn't going to land. They don't have the Dragon Tail either. They're going to manage to get the stun there somehow. And one more Breathe Fire. Oh, my goodness. He actually... Did he miss that Breathe Fire?
Well, I think he did, but Spearbreaker had the bash and 17%.
Oh gosh, and with that, a hookshot with the vision. Can she blink away? No such luck. Silence as well on top of the searing chains, and Quap once again. She is squishy. You're an in hero. You don't exactly survive a lot of action.
Yeah, one thing to mention is Clockwork did max Rocket Flare, which is something that, some people build it. It's a lot more common in Chinese Dota to max Rocket Flare than in, let's say, NA Dota or EU Dota. I think NA and EU go for the max battery assault a lot more. But I really think the Rocket Flare has done a lot for him this game. It's done, like, battery assault does do a lot of damage, but during team fights, it's not as strong, and we saw Rocket Flare be really useful top lane, and even just the low cooldown on it to be able to scout around the map is really useful for him.
Yeah, I think another really important difference to mention that may have factored in is people like opting for Rocket Flare when they're up against a push lineup because it can draw creeps off of the tower. AA is just dead. Full stop, gonna try to walk away. Searing Chain's gonna come out. Goodbye, AA, and I feel like they've got to realize at some point there's a ward this far up, right? Maybe they think it was creeps. Oh, will there be a hook shot? There is, and now they've got the Mystic Flare on top. There is nothing they can do. Quap can't even use that Sonic Wave because the Blade Mail's up. Not that it would actually kill anyone.
And that's the issue with picking a DK into a Clockwork. Clockwork can just hook him, and this Skywrath pick is really doing work. You just drop the ultimate, and DK is deceptively tanky, as I said at the start. He has Power Treads, Overclock, Bracer. He shouldn't be dying if you look at it from like a logical standpoint. He has like a ton of armor. He has 15 armor. He has like 1600 HP, I believe, maybe a little less. He's still a really tanky hero, but just with all the magic damage they have, they're able to burst him really quickly.
Yeah, and really well played, as you said. The DK came out, and then immediately pretty whop getting that Skywrath. I really like this from FT. So.
Well, Bounty might get the courier again.
Oh yeah, just bounty hunter things. That is courier number two. Unfortunately, this one very, very poor. It was a poor courier. It had nothing on it. So, it's still good to get the courier. It's almost like tower bounty gold.
Yeah, I think it's close now because tower bounty got nerfed a couple patches ago.
It's of course better to be the person who kills the tower. But like, if you're the person who kills the tower, I think it's better, but for the rest of your team, oh gosh, he misses the hookshot! I'm not quite sure what happened there, I think this fellow dies anyway, but he's gonna get off an ice blast. Can his team capitalize? Nobody is anywhere nearby.
I think it's gonna be a free tower and Oshan for, FT, I think. What were you gonna say?
I just think it's really rough here for an AA, as he's working on his Midas, he's of course gonna go Aghanim's, he's actually finished off the Midas. But you don't have great fight potential, you want to be getting levels, you want to be away from your team so you can throw those big AA blasts, and it's just not working out for him against this very mobile lineup of FT.
Yeah, Clockwork's doing really well. When you pick Clockwork against AA here, it means AA can't really split push, you can't really, where AA really wants to be biased how he's farming while the rest of his team is trying to play aggressive and he can come in and gank that way. But when he versus Clockwork, Clockwork can be anywhere, and if you don't have vision of him, it's a really risky play because you're one of the few heroes in this game that can get solo killed by Clockwork. I think the only other hero right now is Bounty Hunter, and it's going to be really difficult to get a hook on Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, now Bounty Hunter did see the invis coming out of ZMSJ, and we also have Bounty Hunter they're right on top of each other. I don't think Bounty Hunter knows. Something I wanted to mention, because he went phase boots as opposed to, there's a variety of other builds, of course, as you mentioned, boots of travel, and you can also go drums instead. It does mean that ZMSJ has a very early Battle Fury timing this patch. 25 minutes. He got his at 16.
Oh, he is really firm, like you said. He's 2-1 and 2. He has 120 CS, he's not going to slow down either. He can win Battle Fury, he's going to be farming quickly. Yep. And it looks like they might go for a kill on mid.
They've got the Remnants coming in, they managed to throw out that Concussive Shot, but here is the turn coming out, they cancel it! AA Blast is actually going to hit on two, a nice AA Blast coming out there, but Paparazzi, he is leading the charge, he has his Yasha, he has his BKB, and let's see what else he could be going. They've got Bounty Hunter playing behind them, but immediately a ward drop. That is not a sentry maybe that they wanted. Either way, this tower, it is going in favor of the Dire. And we do have a charge coming out somewhere. Bounty Hunter is straight up dead. Dust as well to seal the deal, and that charge is cancelled. So another easy kill for the lineup of FT.
Yeah, and one thing, Shadow Fiend did opt to go straight BKB. Unlike most other Shadow Fiend players, he didn't go for S and Y. He just said, if I get BKB now, I can push high ground, I can do a lot of things. Because without, like Quap ulti, they don't really have any damage that's physical. They have maybe Spirit Breaker does some physical damage, Bounty Hunter maybe, but besides that, it seems to be all magical until they hit late game when DK will have items. So this early BKB is going to make Shadow Fiend pretty much invulnerable to anything that FTD can throw at them.
I'm still concerned, even if they do hit late game for FTD, it feels like maybe they've been a bit outdrafted. This DK, you can optimize him. Oh,
Radiant's
Clockwork's
top
actually
tower
getting
is
really
under
close to that
attack.
Axe. Well, he's almost at the halfway point. I feel like you don't have the late game against an Ember Spirit SF by any means for FTD, and this Dragon Knight, he's so far behind at this point. He is fifth on the net worth chart. Right, oh, now fourth, but he's tied with a Clockwork.
Yeah, and I think when they drafted him, I think they really wanted him to get maybe a Blink Dagger and try to kind of gank with him. But when they lose early game that hard, which I don't think they expected, they felt their lineup was going to be strong early
Radiant's
game.
bottom
And
tower is under
what happens when
attack.
you lose that hard is it means DK is kind of forced into a
Radiant
BKB.
structures are
He doesn't really
fortified.
want to go BKB, but if he doesn't, it means they lose the game. And I like to call BKB a kind of
Dire's
game-losing
middle
item
tower
in this
is under
situation.
attack.
It's a lose if you do go BKB, and it's a lose if you don't. Because if he goes
Radiant's
Blink Dagger,
bottom
it
tower
means that they
is
can't
under
really
attack.
fight. And, sorry.
We've got the
Radiant's
hookshot coming out,
bottom
and
tower
Quan Chi, I think, had a second to blink away. They didn't use it. Winter's Curse on the AA. They don't want anybody to escape. And again, another big pick of Bounty Hunter. He's looking for
Radiant's
couriers
bottom tower
again,
is under
working on
attack.
his mech, I believe. And what do you do here as FTD? You've got smokes on cooldown. Oh goodness, Spirit Break is actually going for the charge through. Oh, he's going for the charge on that bot lane, wanting to make sure SF knows who's boss, but he's just gonna walk it away, or is he? SF not going for it. I feel like you've got a smoke. If you can kill any of these heroes, of course, you're falling further and further behind. They're becoming really big bounties on FT, but you need more than that, maybe. I just don't think you have the late game, so unless maybe some mistakes are made by FT,
Dire's
I'm not quite
turret
sure how you
has
get back
been
in this
killed.
by FTD.
It's gonna take some really good play by FTD, and it's gonna take some really bad play by Fenton. I'm never gonna pronounce that right.
You can just say FT.
It's
Or
FT.
fan.
Okay, it says FTD and FT, so
Yeah, it's a bit
it's a little
bad. It's
confusing.
not.
But it means that they have to group up. They have to get hit by the
Oh,
Quap ult.
speaking of which, we have a Dragon Tail coming out. They're gonna get the AA blast on it as well. Not going for the AA, just not paying off. And now they actually still have the DK alive. Can they do any sort of thing? Oh goodness, but the Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains combo, everybody is going down. Battery Assault, why are you sticking around, DK? I know you've got a BKB, but I don't think you have the damage output to kill anyone. He's maybe gonna make it back to the fountain, or is he? Maybe another Sleight of Fist? No, they decide not to go for it, and actually Bounty Hunter gets a kill on the back line. Not words I was expecting to say this game, and he might get a second one. No tower angle toggle. This is the mistakes they needed. Dragon Knight coming back in. He's got a Dragon Tail. He's got a little bit of damage. Can he get it with just a little bit more? Two more auto attacks. The tower's gonna finish him off. And this is suddenly a fantastic team fight. I think that is the best they could hope for in FTD. They have somewhat outdone Team Fan. And yeah, holy cow. They, with the track kills included, they have gotten themselves about 2k gold in the bank over Fantuan.
That was the misplay that needed to happen. Shadow Fiend was sitting way too far up, and they just bursted him down with Quap and AA ult, and then that meant that for the rest of the fight it was 4v5, and even though they didn't have their big ultimates, if it's 4v5 like that, they don't have enough damage. Shadow Fiend's their main damage dealer until Ember Spirit gets his crit, or he's going for Manta style. Skywrath has one source of damage, which is his ultimate, and once he uses that, he's pretty much out of mana. Clockwork doesn't do damage himself, he kind of just runs around the fight, and Winter Wyvern doesn't do damage either.
Yeah, really well done by FTD on noticing that mistake, picking off the Shadow Fiend and just the spiral of death afterwards, even though they also lost four, certainly bigger for them, not only with track, but with the rubber band effect. And if that keeps happening, we're maybe going to be seeing the game go their way. But Queen of Pain, she hasn't even finished her Orchid, and the Mont is almost up on Ember Spirit.
Yeah, is she going Orchid? She is. Oh,
Yep.
she's gonna finish it now, but if she dies, this is gonna
Oh.
be big.
Yeah, she's dead. She's lost a lot of gold, and again, the Orchid getting further and further away. Do you think switching up the lanes could have helped them, or maybe is this just a pure case of it looks like FT has FTD's number? Oof, phrasing.
I think they laned okay. They didn't win their lanes as hard as possible. I think Quap made some misplays versus Clockwork. There's no reason for her to ever die in that lane. They didn't really
Sharp
win
has
their lanes as
fallen
hard
into
as
the
they wanted
dark.
to. Bounty Hunter didn't play that well. I mean, I'm not gonna say you didn't play well, but the rotations you made just didn't work out, and that happens sometimes, especially when you pick a Bounty Hunter
Yeah.
like this. That for them to win the lanes, the Bounty Hunter needs to get high levels, and he needs to make these kills happen, and it just didn't work out.
Now,
And
Bounty Hunters.
Queen of Pain also, I was gonna mention that she could have bought Orchid there, but it's the little things like that are kind of putting them behind. If she had bought out right there, she would have had Orchid and Clockwork cooking on the Ancient Apparition bottom. Free
Yeah,
kill.
free kill indeed. We talked about this a bit in the draft, but Clockwork always able to catch. There's a lot of
Dire's
people here
turret
who you
has
can
fallen
catch
into
and
the
kill
dark.
off. Killed the Dire
Dire's
Courier
top
again.
tower
That
is
gets us the
under
Blink
attack.
Dagger up on the DK.
Radiant's
Wow, this
bottom tower
Dire's
is
Courier,
under
I think
attack.
that's time number 4. So.
Yeah, I know it's number three, I think.
Okay, well, it is not gonna be the best either way,
Radiant's
even with
bottom
their courier
tower
down.
is
This
under
AA
attack.
blast, what happened there? I think a really big mistake coming out of this AA, and that may cost them the racks. You can't fight without that. I think they may have seen it. I'm not 100% sure. Either way, AA taking a lot of damage from that Sleight of Fist, and it looks like this is gonna be a racks going down. Paparazzi, Winter's Curse onto Monet, and she is just in that Mystic Flare, manages to blink over to the side, and they punish that Skywrath. But now we've already got one racks down in the range. It's the easier racks to take. Is it going to follow? Searing Chains coming out again. AA is down. No AA balls coming out for that entire team fight. They get one death down on the SF. Sonic Wave coming out as well as a scream, but it is not enough. Killing herself on that Blade Mail, it looks like. And now Ember Spirit, he is just zoning everybody. They've got him locked down for a second there. The Cold Embrace, is it going to save his life? The charge through. Do they have more damage? But he just remnants away. He's deciding to come back in. No, he's going to TP home maybe and then come back in. And oh, Spirit Breaker, he's doing his best. He's taking a lot of damage from people, but the blade mail has worn off and the own charge isn't going to be enough. Finally, the BKB coming out of Paparazzi and the Ember Spirit is back and this Rax is gone. The full set Bounty Hunter did end up getting Clockwork in the back line, so a nice huge bounty for him, but I don't know what to say there. That AA blast, I think. I don't know if maybe he misclicked? It was probably a misclick.
No, it wasn't. A couple things went wrong that fight. DK picked up the Blink Dagger, which I talked about earlier, which I thought was really important. But what happened is, so AA used his ultimate right on the high ground push, and DK bought Blink Dagger and tried to blink in. But right as he was blinking in, Ember Spirit used Sleight of Fist and canceled the blink. So DK ended up just popping ultimate. AA Blast missed because he didn't blink in, and his blink got canceled by the Ember Spirit Sleight of Fist, and he just kind of stood there and had to walk in and try to stun them. So it wasn't really a planned play by Ember Spirit, but the way it worked out is that Ember Spirit was able to cancel the blink and make a huge play for his team that maybe saved that fight.
And then a rather small play coming out of the Skywrath, missing the Mystic Flare there, but still a nice attempt. He is going to be having a Rod of Atos up very soon. It's not a bad pickup, it's one of the cheapest ways to get so much int. I'm a little surprised we don't see something like a Glimmer Cape, because they're sieging high ground now.
We'll see. Oh man, Spirit Breaker is TPing out. I thought he was gonna get caught by Ember Spirit there.
Yeah, looks like
But,
he'll be A-okay.
Bounty Hunter has a lot of items. I'm surprised he hasn't picked up Glimmer himself either. There's not a lot of Glimmers. You have one on Winter Wyvern, but you don't have any on the opposing team. There's not really anyone good to pick it up on besides maybe Spirit Breaker, which kind of limits it.
Yeah, I do feel
Bounty
like it's a really nice item though in this game for both sides. Oh, and we've got the blink forwards onto Paparazzi. AA Blast is gonna hit this time, and that is a dead Shadow Fiend. Now Ember Spirit though, he may just clean up the rest of them. They've got a Blade Mail doing some good work. Monet is not gonna fall, able to blink away, but will they just follow her down? And now AA trying to delay the time there. Spirit Breaker has bought back. I guess really doesn't want to lose this high ground siege, and we have got DK in the middle of no man's land. Spirit Breaker charging in, trying to make sure to save this DK's life, but it may be at the cost of his own, but instead they kill off the Skywrath. Maybe they can get more. There are tracks all over the place, and they're getting these track kills. These are huge. Sleight of fist almost killing everyone, and it's the rocket from the clockwork that we talked about doing mad work, and now with the blade mail up, they just can't touch him. They monitor off the track. They're going to be able to throw out another one if they can keep this Bounty Hunter alive at all. The hookshot onto him, though, and Bounty Hunter is in a sad, sad place. He manages to pop up a wand, but he is killed by the cogs, and Monet blinks over to the side. She gets that track kill. She's got the silence. A gem has also popped out of the Bounty Hunter, but it doesn't, not the Bounty Hunter, the clockwork. It doesn't matter because there's nobody there on, did he just kill his own bottle?
Yeah, he did just deny his own bottle.
Sure, you don't want to leave it there for the Radiant, you know, that would be...
you know, maybe Ancient Apparition finally gets the bottle and you lose the game off of that. It's game losing, man.
Yeah, so, I would argue definitely a team fight that was somewhat salvaged by FTD. They got quite a few kills there, and when we look at the net worth chart, we're going to see, you know, at least it's not shooting right back down. But we're at a 14,000 net worth deficit. We're at a 12,000 experience deficit for FTD. They technically held a tier 2 there, and tier 2s in these two lanes are notoriously difficult to hold just because of the high ground issues around here. So, I mean, all in all, decent, but they're still in a huge hole.
Yeah, and Ember Spirit's getting bigger and bigger. He didn't die that fight. He now has finished his Daedalus, which is his first big damage on him. And this means that if he gets a good crit on Ancient Apparition, I think he can one-shot, like, definitely one-shot Ancient Apparition at 700 health. And with one good crit from Ember Spirit, he will die right away.
Yeah, this Ember Spirit, I mean, he has so much farm. He is huge. Been surviving these engagements. 216 creeps, 10, 1, and 7. He's not slowing down anytime soon. So, Bounty Hunter has finished up the Guardian Greaves, though, with a couple of those big kills. I think the kill on the clockwork earlier really helping him out for getting that mech. And this is something for the team. We've got the stun. Paparazzi, will he just fall again? The Winter's Curse, though, it's huge. It's standing them in the Mystic Flare. BKB coming out. Is it too little, too late? Again, the cogs kill up Bounty Hunter and Xion. He tries to return some damage, but that doesn't work in Sleight of Fist, and this could just be GG. Are we going to a game 2 right here and now? And we are. I didn't think I was right when I called that.
I don't think they had buybacks. They might have, but...
No, they have no buybacks on their lineup, unfortunately. And realizing it's over, I think maybe next game they'll try for a different strat. What are your thoughts?
I don't think you can pick DK against a lineup like this. I like the idea. It just didn't work out in any phase. Maybe you can pick something like that, but you can't pick Bounty Hunter. Their lineup was really greedy, and it relied a lot on making sure that their ganks happened. And when ganks fail like that, they had no way to catch up and kind of get themselves back into the game.
Yeah, so with that, folks, we'll be heading you into a game to Lickety-Split. Once again, I am Llama Down Under. We are casting the Star Ladder Chinese scene and I-League. It's really exciting stuff. We just had Fantuan take a victory over FTD. And I am at Llama Down Under on Twitter. I am joined by the wonderful Noble Wings with a Z or a Z, depending on where you're from, who's also under that handle on Twitter. I'll make sure to say hello in chat after this game to make sure you all get that info. Once again, thank you all for watching. We'd love your feedback on how to get better. And please stick around for a few words from the Star Ladder sponsors. Peace out, folks, and see you in game 2.